Hi, it's Susanna Choi, and I want to welcome you to Mayor Bloomberg's Putin-ville. This is the New York City we're living in. Mike Bloomberg says that crime is down. It's not true. Mike Bloomberg is going nationally saying we need to get rid of guns, but what you don't hear about is that the NYPD are fixing violent crimes. You'll hear more about it at Adrian Schoolcraft's trial. He's suing the NYPD for $50 million. But in fact, I was a victim of a violent crime at Dr. Andrew Fagelman, and I want to thank everyone, thanks and gratitude, for helping the YouTube to have close to 14,500 views of me being threatened with bodily harm, of me being punched. When I'm punched, the YouTube goes black. She continued ripping out my hair, ripped out an earring, kicked me several times, but I tried to. She only made contact with my vagina, my vaginal area, once with her bare foot. This was a doctor's office, so she violated my body, including my vaginal area, my patient privacy, and my patient rights. You think the New York Post, two news reporters from New York Post talked to me about it. The New York Post editors are so misogynist. They're going after Eliot Spitzer, but they're true misogynists, and I'm proof. You don't know about my story, right? But everyone wants to know about it because we all go to a doctor's office and we want to feel safe. And it's such a violation, on top of which the NYPD fixed it, and Internal Affairs has been sitting on it for 10 months as if someone inside the NYPD high up is involved in fixing this violent crime. It's an incredible story, and people want to know. But the New York Times hasn't picked it up. New York Daily News, who won't allow me to post comments. They send me junk mail all the time on behalf of their advertisers, but won't let me post a comment. The New York Times often censors my comments. And basically, I'm a huge critic of Mayor Bloomberg and his puppet Christine Quinn, the 911 tech corruption that they've not been held accountable for, as well as the tsunami of community crushing development, as well as pushing through an illegal third term, and that our infrastructures are falling apart. The street conditions are the worst you've ever seen them, and below them, the subways, a lot of them need major expansion, and it all involves a lot of abuse of money and power, starting with Bloomberg, Christine Quinn, and everyone they're in league with. And so I guess what I'm telling you is that all the editors and some of the owners are so misogynist and so hateful of any person that's got the courage to speak up. I mean, they say they're Americans and proud to be Americans, but it was our founding fathers and mothers that dared to speak up and dared to fight for rights that have this country that we have now. It's thanks to them. But God forbid you dare to speak up and don't do what these power brokers want. And in their minds, women like me should keep my head down and my mouth shut. So I was violently assaulted without surgery. I would have lost vision in my eye. There's more neck damage, including nerve. I have a lot of tingling sensations, and it goes up my arms. And you don't know about this because it is not part of the news. Just like Mike Bloomberg's critics are all silenced. When I protest outside a press conference for Mayor Bloomberg, I literally walked away. Because even a critic standing anywhere near Bloomberg in his press conferences is a threat. When in fact, according to America, our First Amendment rights, I'm not a threat to him. There's no reason that I can't stand there and shout about our 911 tech corruption. I have a freedom of speech and it's a public sidewalk. This is the New York, Mike Bloomberg's New York, and that shows you that you haven't read about this in any newspaper. How misogynist the editors are, and they want to talk about Meaner and Spitzer when they are true misogynists supporting me being violently assaulted. Without surgery, I would have lost my vision. Violently assaulted at a doctor's office, not covered in the news. My Wikipedia page on me being censored, created by activists and other activists that joined in later, removed during this process, as were two YouTubes, but at least Google apologized, returned the YouTubes of the assaults, and the detective's no arrest YouTube of the assault. But Wikipedia hasn't returned the censorship page on me. Wikipedia, who talks about rights and freedom and everything, are as guilty. Someone in Wikipedia is very involved, and I wonder if they're connected to Bloomberg and even the NYPD and Delite Hooks and Dr. Fagelman. So why is my Wikipedia page on censorship removed after the YouTubes on Delite Hooks assaulting me fixed by the NYPD? Why were they removed? And like I said, Google did apologize and give them back. Stay tuned.